I take you all around these parts, boy, let's take a ride. Yeah, I put that on Wayne, that's on Shade of God. 12 o'clock on Banshees, that's how we making time. You might see squads, cause bikes ring bonds. I'm like, they gotta know the balls from Harlem to Baltimore. You can hit a ramp by the plastic scraping on the floor. I'm trying to show them more than posting at that corner store. You just gotta hit the gas, homie, all in all. I know this bike life, I know what this life like. I'm blipping that throttle, streets got me feeling like Mike. Right. I'm talking A-Fab and Cherry Hill. For years they heard about the stories and we legends still. Let's take a ride from my side to your side. Let's take this worldwide. Let's take a ride. Ooh, let's take a ride. Oh, this for Willie Wayne and this for Shay. Let's take a ride. Ooh, let's take a ride.
Man!
Yeah, what? Those thoughts are fucking bullshit.
Wow.
I can't start. But then you can start a little bit.
I can start.
Just a little bit. Give a little bit.
Man, we got this guy. We got this guy, right?
Who is he?
I ain't even gonna tell you who it is. Just know this motherfucker keep telling me that he coming back out. He great ride, get back on his bullshit.
He do that a lot though, cause he dress up a lot.
That's because he been hanging around Cat and Charlie.
And then he hang around them celebs and shit. And he a little different. Take planes and shit.
Man,
I remember the old young, the young dude. That's why I like the little young one, the little young kid when he was young. He was dope.
Yeah, definitely.
That's who we like. Let's see.
That's when he had the twinkle in his eye. Yeah. When he actually wanted to ride. Right. Now he a rapper in a fashion. A model. He a model. We gonna man, tell the model come out here.
Let's
and
model.
Get the model out here. Model some clothes and some shit.
Get him the model, y'all.
Here with a Monster energy drink.
Monster drink. Tell Monster what's up. We right here.
For sure.
Okay.
No, that's how we coming. For sure.
You should have had two of them.
I should have brought them in for all of us. You're right.
We'll talk later. That's a, that's
I don't
a,
drink
a,
none
let's
of that
get,
shit.
Let's
I don't
come
do
through
nothing. What's up with this old head?
I don't drink.
Nah, he don't drink. He gonna drink when we decided he gonna drink when we cut the first M check.
I still ain't drinking.
Bitch, you drinking?
I ain't drinking.
We gonna smoke weed.
Y'all gonna give me a motherfucking lemonade or jumbo half and half or something because I ain't drinking that shit.
Hip hop chicken, huh?
No, I don't even want that shit.
He wants the fish and chips from New York. That's all he wants, the shrimp and chips.
Sure.
The seafood. Let's get straight to it, though.
Yeah, for sure.
I look. Ain't no filter, nigga.
Ain't no filter.
No, definitely ain't no filters. No filter.
You call my phone and tell me you ain't want no filter.
No filter.
Now, and
no
you
filter.
Jump on my page talking about when your interview. Well, we motherfucker. Well, here's your interview.
Yeah. Here's your shit.
Here's your interview.
Here's your fucking shit.
For I had to come here because I feel like this is like a great platform for the culture. You know what I mean? And then you got one of the OGs and another OG, Shay.
But he an older G.
You get what I'm saying? So yeah, he definitely getting old. He can look at all that gray hair, man. What's up? Yeah, this shit.
We still here.
But for sure, I wanted to come on here though, and just like, I feel like this is gonna be a great platform for us all. This is gonna be our radio station for bike life. You know what I mean? So I feel like this is gonna be big for our culture, and it's gonna go somewhere.
But I wanna start from the younger dude with the twinkle in his eye. Young boy that was riding a pedal bike and said he wanted. I mean, you got to, everybody knows who you are, yada yada.
Sure.
But give me history on that kid on the pedal bike.
Yeah, we're gonna start back from the Secret Society DVD.
The Secret Society.
When he was really in the pedal bike, putting the peace sign up in the camera.
Let's go.
We can go back.
What
that
year
far.
Was that?
Shit. Oh, that was 03, I believe.
That was that had to have been probably.
How old was you? Then? How old was you?
03. What was I? Damn. What was that? 18 years? What's that?
I don't know. 03 is
20. 18 years ago.
18 years, yeah.
God damn. 18 years ago. So, what's that? I'm 24 right now. What's that?
Right.
So, that was what? I was 6, 7.
You was like 7 years old.
Yeah, that's crazy.
Like 7 years old.
Yeah, for
you
sure.
You had the twinkle in your eye then. The twinkle.
I still got the twinkle.
Right,
what
but what was
about?
That? What, all right, so that kid at 7, 8 years old, what was your mission?
My mission then was really to just get on dirt bikes from get up. Well, I was on dirt bikes and pedal bikes at the same time. So around when I turned like 10, I was fully on dirt bikes now. But from then, even my bike was broke, so I'd be back on a pedal bike or something was going on with the bike. But
tell them what you was riding.
Oh, you know, my first bike was a Pep Boys bike. Right. My first bike was a Pep Boys. What was it, CC90? It was a CC90. Then I got the 110 with the wiggly front wheel. You remember that?
The wiggly nasty front wheels. Basically, hoopties.
Hoopties. I come through on hoopties. And what's so crazy is back then I didn't know how to. No, I ain't never know how to sit down.
Oh, he would do a Superman
all day. And knee knock. All I could do was Superman
on
and knee knock.
On the 90s.
Yeah, all he would do all day
back
long.
Back then, all I would do was Superman and 90. Superman and.
So So we seeing 10 years old.
10 years old.
10 years old.
For sure.
With the pack.
For sure.
On the 90. Yep. Superman.
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
And when we tried to teach him how to ride a clutch, he wouldn't do it.
And then after that, what I did, my first
he wouldn't do it.
My first
ride a clutch.
I think from that, my first real shit was what the XL50. Remember? It was the XL50.
The XL50. That was the actual. That was the first actual.
My
real dirt
bike. Yeah, my real dirt bike. Yeah. From after the Pep Boys.
Graduating from the Pep Boys to the XR50.
To the XR50 now.
Heavy.
Because the XR50 was more powerful than the Pep Boys joints. Okay. Yeah, for sure. Yeah.
So you said the transition start coming when you was on the XR50.
Yeah, when
so
I
was getting more in tune.
I was getting more in tune. No, I was always in tune because you got to think about it. Like, I learned from, Var taught me how to ride. Like, he put me on my first dirt bike.
Okay.
Var,
that's the original 12 o'clock board. The
original.
Original VHS tape.
For sure.
Right.
Yeah. So he put me on my brother XR70.
Right.
And we was at Douglas and shit. So he put me on the front and he on the back. Mm-hmm. So we riding around like the track and Var on the back, but he happened to jump off. And when he jumped off, I don't even know he had jumped off and shit. And I'm still riding. So now I'm coming around the track, about to come to a complete stop. And ain't nobody back there, so they all trying to, like, grab me and stop me and shit, because I ain't know he was out the back. Right. And then after that, ever since, I just been...
It was on.
Yeah, it was on after that. It was on.
Okay, so now we're moving up the ladder. Where we at? 10 now, Wayne? 10?
Yeah.
All right, let's go straight to the 13.
No, though. But...
No, all right, let's go. Yeah. You tell me we're at 10.
No, at... That was at 6'7".
6'7".
When Bob first put me on my first dirt bike. You know
let's go
saying?
To 10.
Okay.
The 10-year-old chino.
Yeah.
What was he about?
That was the 10-year-old chino. I was about. That was me on the XR50 in the pack. I would say
that's when he was actually hitting
fully
the town
in the pack. Yeah, like, fully in the pack,
riding around the entire city. Yeah. With the pack.
He wasn't pulling to the side
pack.
And
no.
Letting the pack go by and then see y'all later.
Yeah,
no,
I was in
the early
at that
age.
Time.
He was just up wheel deal area.
Yeah, right. Popping in.
At 10, he was actually going with us.
Yeah, okay. That's
he
a
was
fact.
Going through the whole city with us.
So now, when did you start transitioning to when it made sense to you, Wayne? Like, yo, okay. He on it.
That was when I came
when
and
he
got
came,
that.
When he came, what? I don't remember who bike it was, but he came up my house banging on my door because he finally rode a clutch. Who the fuck bike was that?
When Al put me on. Al had put me on that 65, that KTM 65 Al had in the back. It was Scola, actually Scola's.
Okay.
That KTM 65.
Now, I remember he banging on my front door. I come outside and he like, I can ride a clutch now. Yeah. I did it.
Shit.
Right. And I'm sitting there like,
sure.
Boy, we been trying to put you on the clutch, but he was scared to do it. He didn't want to do it. The most people we could get him to ride was a PW80.
Yeah.
Mm.
And he would wheelie the PW80, but he wouldn't ride a clutch.
That's a fact.
So the 65, now you in your bag on the 65?
That was my only road to 65, like one time.
That's when
though.
He learned how to ride the
clutch.
That's
when I learned how to ride the clutch.
So what was the switch after the 65?
The switch after the 65 was when I came and bought the 85 from you. Y'all started calling it a...
We called it a 75.
A 75.
Wow.
Because it ain't had no back fit or nothing.
My man BY was like, yo, I'm tired of Shorty on that little piece of shit.
Yeah.
He like, Wayne, what you got up there with a clutch that he can ride? So
that's
he came and got it from me and gave it to him, but the bitch ain't have a lot of power. We used to laugh at him until they were like, yo, that ain't no 85. That's a motherfucker 75.
So that's when I started coming at Wayne neck. I started coming at Wayne neck when I first did... The whole Hilton Parkway.
On the 75.
And I started calling
on the fake
Wayne
85.
Out on the 75.
Yeah, the fake 85.
He was calling you out on the fake 85.
Yeah, the fake 85. Okay.
But yeah, so on that was when that video came out when I first did the number. I did the whole Hilton Parkway.
How old was you then?
Was I like 12?
Yeah, it's like about 12.
Yeah, like 12. 12. I was probably like 12. I did the whole Hilton Parkway. I'm talking about, I thought that shit was like, I thought that was some shit. Well, really, it was some shit at the time. Wayne was the only person doing that.
And you did.
Like, literally. Yeah, Wayne was the only person doing that.
You gotta understand the dynamic. She was 12.
Yeah, that's a fact.
So
that's a fact.
It's a big hype to be 12 years old and still doing it with him.
Yeah, for sure. No, not Wayne was doing some other.
I mean, but still.
That was just
a
popular video that you knew. Wayne coming around in them big ass butters.
In the 5XT.
In the 5XT.
Yeah, for sure.
That had on a coat.
Like, they the videos and shit that I remember and, like, used to really pay attention to. Niggas really don't even know about them videos. Like, I got a chance to ride with other riders like Silly Willie. They don't even know who Silly Willie is. That's Hawk. I don't even know if they know Hawk. That's Silly Willie. Yeah, you get what I'm saying?
I asked you about the other day. We got to get him.
Yeah, for sure.
You said that was the only dude that really went at you, right?
That was the only dude who can go pound for pound with me on distance. Yeah. He was Silly Willie.
He was
at the time. And he, the things that he was doing back then, this was roughly 97, 98.
Yeah.
He was Supermaning a two stroke, slow wheeling.
First person I seen Supermaning.
Slow wheeling. Not in the power bag, slow wheeling Superman. Wow. And making U turns on the Superman.
Yeah, he was serious.
Yeah, he was dope.
Serious. Yeah, we definitely got to get him up here.
Yeah, that's a fact.
So I said, now we have the 12 year old kid. You want an 80, you want the fake 85. 12 years old. Now, let's... Right, so now this is where I catch up at, and then you bring me from here.
Right.
So now, I was put on to Chino and, you know, all that from Steezo Weasel. Mm-hmm. And he showed me a video. And the first video I seen, you was on the blue bike. A blue 450 or two, whatever.
It was the Hot Wheels one that blew up, right?
And you was like, yeah, whatever, whatever. It was a blue bike you was on, but you did the no-handers. I think it was a 450 or 250.
That
was a
250, two-stroke.
250,
two-stroke.
That was
boss.
Right.
That was
boss. Now, how old was you then? 13?
That was actually around the same year. That was
the same time.
That was around the same
so
year.
So you was 13.
Probably 13.
Yeah.
13 on the
250. Like
13. Yeah, definitely. So he advanced that fast, that quickly, yeah. That same year.
Yeah. That's super.
Yeah, that shit was crazy.
That was super. But I'm saying, Wayne, from your point of view, these was your riders. This come from all your team and all that. This motherfucker was 13 on the 250.
Yeah, that's a fact.
How did you look at it? Like, is on? Did you see a bigger picture or you just was watching?
No, I always seen a bigger picture. You know, I always was one step ahead of everything. Mm-hmm. But as a kid, you know, they don't listen to what you're saying when you're not saying it. So you be saying like, no, you gotta do this, you gotta do that. And they be like, just put gas in my bike so I can pop these motherfucker wheelies mm-hmm. and I'm good. And I'd be right, like, sure. All
right,
whatever.
Right.
It is what it is.
See, that's what I think. For me, as being a historian and the way I study, the way I look at it, mm-hmm. when you 13 years old at that time, like your name was buzzing so crazy, but nobody really knew the age.
Yeah, and to get into that, like that's what people don't be really realizing. Like I already had like the city. Am I right?
Yeah,
I already had like
you
the
already
city.
He had the city as the backing.
I had
already.
The city as the backing, like. He was the youngest one right. doing this. Right. I was the only young one at that time. It really wasn't 13, nobody really on dirt bikes really around my age. So, and then what, like a year or two later, that's when the shit with Meek came about. And then he just expanded my shit. You know what I'm
saying? But before Meek, though.
Before then, we had to damn near sign him out like a field trip. We like really did ass. We had to go talk to his mother and be like, look, we're going to bring him back.
Yeah,
by 10 fact. When it gets dark to be in the house for school tomorrow.
For sure.
Like, we really had to go.
Basically, I'll bring him back home, but you babysitting him. But
yeah, rocking. We like, he going with us, he going to ride, we have him back by 10, all that type of shit. That's how it had to be.
Now, listen, no, because I remember a lot of shit. Chased in the mall.
I got chased in the
mall. How old was you when you got chased in the mall?
I got chased in the mall. That was on that 250. But But before we get into that,
I remember...
When I first got on the big bikes, the 250s, I used to always get on my ass because I could never get it started. Mm-hmm. That shit? Like, I let the
it's
bike
the same way you tell the kids. Like, you can't start it,
right
you can't ride it.
Like, 15 minutes. I'd be sitting right there for like 15 minutes trying to get this shit started.
That motherfucker
said. You know, them shits give you that kickback. I was little shit. They give me that kickback then and not my
But he always
ride.
Wanted to ride the bigger bikes.
Always wanted
he
the
was
big shit.
Attracted to the bigger bikes.
For sure.
But it's like, it was just something about a small person on a big bike. That was the same thing with Dad.
You had the other
with
little
Nail,
short dude.
With
the other
Lips. All the short guys on bigger bikes. It just looked it better. Yeah. You know, as they ride. It
was
like
Lips was super little on that motherfucker. Like, the bike was just he
that
just
right there.
Staring
he,
the bike. That's one of your mentors too, though.
That's where I get all my shit from.
Swag, everything.
My whole swag come from him. Like I just took it to another level.
Right.
Like, my whole everything, I studied everything that nigga did. Like,
we had a big conversation.
I wanted to be just like that nigga.
But listen, we had a conversation the other day, me and Wayne, about swag. People got swag fucked up.
Yes.
That's a different, no, I'm saying, we just saying in general, like,
they be
swag
thinking,
is.
They be thinking their tricks is swag, and you'd be like, no, it's not.
Swag is just how it feel good. It looks
and not even
it just,
that, it's like a lot of, I be seeing a lot of guys, they They do all
they
the
do
tricks.
All the tricks. They but do it looks all like it and looks like
that's
a robot.
Cool, but
it's robotic.
You don't look comfortable doing this shit. You look like you just let me get this trick off. Let me hurry and get this one off. Let me get this one off. It's like, do you is you comfortable in your element of doing this shit? Like,
top three, who got swag to you?
Top three, I'm giving you Lips for sure. Right. Neil for sure.
Gotta get close to the mic when I say this. Neil is washed up.
I'm giving you Lips for sure, Neil for sure, and I can't because I like a lot of out of town guys. Like
give me
and
two
you
out
know
of
who,
town.
You know another guy who's like
you know who swag I like? Skeet, Miami Skeet.
I love Skeet. That's my guy. Yeah. Like Skeet
he be all over who that don't, motherfucker.
Really Nitty has swag.
Snitty, yeah, Nitty.
Really
Nitty
be
swag.
In the back who I always paid attention to. Ciroc boy. That's my guy.
Oh, yeah.
I told everybody he's not Ciroc boy anymore.
He's not Ciroc boy. Who is he? Not
Ciroc man. Yes. Because he's been Ciroc boy for 20 years. God damn, when is he going to grow up?
Now, I would say he probably like one of the first guys who really looked at like a like somebody that came from Baltimore for a swag to me.
Yeah, he was one of the guys. He come down here. He ain't had to bring a bike.
Like
he
was blend in.
He knew he was going to give him something to ride.
Boy was holding it. He held it down.
Yeah, we had a big debate about swag and who got swag. And you know what I'm saying? And swag, I think a lot of dudes are robotic to me. Like, they do so many combos, but it just don't have grace to it.
Yeah, that's a fact.
And then, but see, another now, when I first came down here, I remember this. You had the black leather coat on with the white sleeves. You just got a white 450.
That was
black leather coat. I'm like, yo, who is this little nigga? And it was like, that's Chino. And you took off. And when you took off, I said to my man LM, I'm like, yo, I never seen no shit. This nigga's too little, my nigga. Yeah. This nigga's too little. And then you start. You just did so much, but was looking at when you looked over in the car. I said, this nigga don't even. I was fucked up.
Ain't even pants
because of the height though. The height and the bike just fucked me up. And I was like, yo, shorty really, really got it.
And then, like, to get into another thing, like, riding in that, I remember riding in that pack, and for a while, I'd be wheeling and shit. Mm-hmm. And I might come past and cut Wayne off. I might come past and cut somebody off or something like that. For a while, I was never looking behind me or just paying attention to what I could do to another rider. Mm. Niggas was pulling me up. Yo, you got to start paying attention. You doing what you do, but you ain't paying attention. You cutting everybody off while you riding.
Was it purposely done or you just having
I'm
fun?
Fresh in. I don't understand. I'm fresh in.
Right. But see, that'd be the older riders be having to pull them to the side and teach them that. Exactly. But a lot of times now, the younger generation don't want to hear it because they feel like, oh, you hating on them. They doing what they doing. You like, nah, we trying to teach you pack etiquette so nobody don't get hurt.
Pack etiquette.
And it'd be a
pack
lot
pack etiquette is a word.
That's a fact. So a lot of guys can ride. A lot of guys can wheelie. Who can really ride?
Right. And that part comes out when
that's
you get chased.
Matter.
Oh,
when you get chased.
That comes out in the chase.
When you get chased, that part comes out. Who can actually ride their bike?
That's what.
Yeah. Let's make the streets great again. I ain't got no time for no hater, yeah, I'm lit. Niggas like bro, he be on some other shit, yeah. Catch me in the post, they ain't talking about a flick. Tryna get these bags up, nigga, come check the drip, 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 drip. I'm bendied out, check the drip, 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 drip. Bloody bottle, check the drip, 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 drip. New timer, check the drip, 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 drip. I keep it locked. Come take the city with me, I'm bringing Billy's with me. I'm bringing these Millies with me, like I'm bringing Diddy with me. Second coming to be out, man.
Any chase I ever been in, I never got caught up straight up. Any chase I ever been in, something even happened to the bike. I ain't never. Well, matter of fact, it was one time I got caught at the gas pump. That was about it.
Right.
But any chase I ever been in, it was something happened to the bike. I don't.
Scariest chase.
I ain't never really had no scariest chase because Wayne, I love it. That's my favorite.
No, you had one. You had one.
Which one was that?
You had. It wasn't even a chase though.
That was that day I wasn't supposed to come out.
Wasn't even a scary chase. No, in fact, you had a couple of them. I remember one when you was getting ready to come outside and the police was at the door.
The ground. Oh.
And he ran back in the house.
Listen, I just brought the 85 from Wayne. It wasn't even 24 hours. My uncle bought the joint. It wasn't even 24 hours yet. We went up Wayne's house. We bought the 85. And then the next day, I'm about to come out. I'm still fresh. You know what I'm saying? This after the 75.
Yeah.
The 85 that was
now he got
75.
Now he had 85
now I got
power.
A real expert, a CR85 expert. I'm bringing that joint out the side door, so I'm trying to start it up. So now I run it down the block trying to jump start it. It don't start up. I'm still fresh. Police happen to hit the corner. I'm like, oh, my God. Police happen to hit the corner. So now as he hitting the corner, I'm running this joint back up to the house now. I'm trying to run it back up to the house and get it into the basement. Right. So I gets it into the basement. I get it into the basement and shit, and I go in the basement and hide in the back of the basement and shit. So the police like banging on the door and shit. So my grandma, she come out there wilding and shit like that. So my grandma, I ain't letting you in there. They get to talking about locking her ass up. She straight over that motherfucking door. She straight over that motherfucking door. No, y'all going in and get his ass.
That nigga barricaded the house, calling my phone. For sure. Yo, what should I do? Shit, nothing you can do. Yeah. You're done.
For sure.
I don't know. It's like the history is so... Basically, what I'm getting from it is just at such a young age, you've been putting it on. Yeah, so I think what people see now is that, like, oh, he ain't riding as much. But when you're doing it at 12 and 11 and 10, it's just...
They used to come at his neck a lot from different states and want to beef and battle with him and then... Realize. Not understand, like, you're a grown man, isn't it, arguing with a kid?
Yo, and not to say no names, we don't want to put no names out there, but I can't vouch for this, and Wayne could co-sign this. Some dude was going at you crazy.
Yeah.
And me and Wayne started getting tight, and we basically blackballed him.
Yeah.
They didn't realize what we did, but we did it because we had to check him. He checked him, and then I'm for like, sure. Yo, you going at shorty 13. He's 13, you can't do that.
It's crazy. Wayne said what he said because, like, I remember, like, riding. Like, when I was riding, it was never about no comp. Not when I was riding, because I still ride. I don't know
what
I
said. Don't let
this when I was really in my bag, it wasn't never about no competition shit. Like, I got, like, the video, the Wild Out Willy Boy, when I got the trench on and shit.
Mm-hmm.
Actually, the video you talking about when I did the no hands, like I'm on that video saying, "What I say, don't nobody want it, this, that, and the third." Da, da, da. But at the time,
nobody ain't say shit.
No, not even that. Nobody ain't say shit. It really was nobody right. in my age caliber or just around.
Not even the age wasn't a factor.
Yeah, the age wasn't even a factor. It was just but around. Really wasn't because I definitely wasn't talking about niggas like you, niggas like Steve, niggas like Charles, because
it wasn't that lit yet.
None of that shit was right. lit. So. I'm feeling myself, and I know this is true facts. Like, ain't nobody fucking with me at the time. Like, nobody.
Confident.
You get what I'm saying? Confident. Because I ain't talking about the niggas who bikes I used to ride and shit like that. The Steves, the Lips, and shit like that. These is niggas I got total respect for. Yeah, tell them.
Because goddamn motherfucker, like, I think, maybe two or three years ago, you finally bought your own damn bike.
What was that? No. I had the 150. The sponsor sent me
Before we got to them, you were spoiled.
For sure.
Yeah, he was spoiled.
He
wouldn't buy a bike for shit.
My whole family was
like, every time he loses a bike, somebody else will buy him a bike.
For sure.
And I'm sitting there like, yo, you need a bike. I'm not buying no bike.
Young as shit. You know what I'm saying? So.
Nah. But I mean, that's such a young age to make noise. It wasn't really no competition.
That's because everybody was behind him. Everybody wanted to see him win.
Yeah.
So everybody's like, yo, you need a bike. Niggas would call my phone constantly. Yo, what you got up there? I got to get him something. What you got?
Yeah, definitely.
That's how you support the move. I was totally on that at one time with my folks. But my thing, going back to the subject, to be so young, to have adults guard you, that wasn't even cool. Not that you paid. You didn't register.
They checking niggas about that shit.
And that's like, you know what's so crazy? Like, that's one of the things that really, like, took me out of it, really. Because it's like, every time I ride, it's not fun no more. You know what I'm saying? They took the fun out of me with riding, really. Because, like, every time I ride, it's a competition. It's like, I really can't ride because I got a nigga right beside me who just trying to go at, right. he might throw a video out. Yeah, I'm fucking him up. Well, this and the third, how you fucking me up? I'm not even, I'm paying you some mind, but I'm just saying, I'm really not paying you no mind to be like, we in competition or nothing like that. I ride because I enjoy the shit.
Yeah, that's that sneak battle shit that we be talking about.
So let me ask you this, because we usually go, put you in the hot seat. The seat already hot, motherfucker.
Sure.
Seat been hot since you touched. But battle-wise, a lot of dudes went at your head. How did you feel about it? Because niggas really wanted to see the battles.
I always felt like niggas couldn't fuck. I still feel like to this day, niggas can't fuck with me. That whole, I'm trying to advance, and I want to help the culture. At that time, I already, like, I know what was up with me, and, like, my mindset of what I was on, I'm untouchable. And I feel I ain't nobody fucking with me. And I'm standing on that. You know what I'm saying? Like, and still to this day, I feel like that, but it just be like, motherfuckers all day, it be like, I want to see CHINO. I want to battle CHINO, just in the third. It'll be pointless for me to sit and battle somebody. What am I like? I feel like I've
and how many times I said that?
I built my whole situation.
Hold on. I'm not even going to listen to me.
I said that shit 100 times. I said it's pointless for him to battle.
When he wasn't even around, he said it.
I said he got everything to lose or nothing to gain. So it's why would he battle anybody? I said, like, even if he battles somebody and he wins, the loser still wins. Because now their name is relevant for actually battling him. So it doesn't make sense to do it.
I'd be like, I ask this question to myself, and even if, because, you know, I don't really get into the internet shit when they be back and forth. I might say one thing, and then I'm just out of it. You get what I'm saying? So my main thing be like, nigga, everybody want to battle me. What do you want? Do you want the fame, or do you want the sponsors and shit like that? Because I didn't get the sponsors don't know who got the longest wheelies or none of that shit.
Right.
You get what I'm saying? The sponsors came to what was marketable. You get what I'm saying? Yeah,
of course. They see the bigger picture.
Yeah, it's the marketable side of it. It ain't about who got the longest wheelie or none of that shit. They felt like I was marketable, and that's how that happened. But I really feel like most of them want the followers and the name off the shit. Like, that's not what I'm in it for. That's just what happened to come. You get what I'm saying? I'm trying to make this shit bigger than life.
But the smartest thing you do, what shows growth with you, that you show maturity, you don't feed into it.
For sure.
And then when you do show love, you show it. Yeah, I mean, you giving people like, yo, I like what you're doing
for
now.
Sure.
So that's dope.
Let's jump back to some characteristic things that the people might want to know. Tell the people about the scar on your nose.
Let's get to that scar.
That scar, you know, I'm coming up Ruskin on some bullshit. I'm coming up with one way. It's just so funny because I ran. It wasn't even my homie fault. I ran into one of my homies' car. He was coming up. He was coming the right way. I'm coming up a one way this way.
The wrong way.
The wrong way.
In the car.
No.
On the bike.
On the dirt bike.
He in the car.
Okay.
I run smack into my homie car. Flip in the air. I'm on the ground like unconscious for like 5 minutes and shit. My whole nose like hanging.
Wow.
My whole nose hanging and shit. But it's just so crazy. They waking me up and shit. As I'm coming, I'm going in the ambulance and shit. I'm waking up as I'm going in the ambulance and shit. So as I'm going in the ambulance, I'm like, whoa, I'll be back. I'm like, I'll be back. So then, like, the next day, this shit's so funny because the next day, I come out the hospital and shit. All my eyes black, my shit wrapped up and shit.
I never understood that whole thing, like, break your nose or something, your eyes get black. Yeah, like I never understood that. Why that happens like that.
So I come out. This shit's so funny. I come out and actually the bike I got hit off. It was a little bit messed up, a little bit and shit. It wasn't really that bad. So I come out the next day, lips on the bike. So I'm trying to get the bike. So he ain't trying. Everybody telling him like, no, don't give him the bike. So I'm trying to jump on that joint. So now I jump on the back with him and just wrap around him and shit. And now me and him get around the block and shit. We get around the block and start fighting over the bike and shit. The bike like laid on the ground and shit, real shit. So then he just jumped on the bike and take off. And I had to walk all the way back around the corner. Just some little funny shit.
Another thing, though, I want to ask. What about when you almost lost your life?
Oh, yeah, that shit was crazy. Like
how that just kind of should have shifted. What was your mind shifted, bike culture? you almost got shot. Explain details, please.
The whole shit with that, when I got shot, it like, that shit like took me out of like.
Where you got shot at?
I got shot in my head. And I got shot in my head. One grazed me, one still in my head. That shit took my whole mindset just out of a lot of shit. Like, I just wanted to dim everything down and just chill, really. Like, and then I, the shit happened with school, then the shit happened with my brother. Yeah. And then I just
right there when that shit happened with your brother.
Like, the crazy thing, when your brother got shot, me and him, me and Shay, we was at the light at the top of your block.
Like,
and we heard it.
We heard it,
right? And I looked down the street and I see all the cars, the police, everything. I'm like, dang, what the fuck just happened down there? So I went to Hip Hop Chicken, and then that's when they said what happened.
So
that shit just took me out of like everything, really. It took me out of like just wanting to. Because I'm young. I was young. You know what I'm saying? What I was? 18?
Just like turning 18.
Yeah. Some shit like that. It just took me out of that shit. And I was done with fucking fame, all that type of shit. You get what I'm saying? Because
and that's the dangers of this city.
No, for sure. That's the dangers. I'm like, at the time, I ain't beefing with nobody or nothing like that. So automatically, I'm focusing it towards somebody hating. Mm. You get what I'm saying? Which everything come back, but I'm like, somebody hating. So that shit just had me on some.
How long
shit.
It took before you just could focus?
It took me like a whole year. Mm. It took me like a whole year to really like get my whole shit together. Like for like riding in cars, all that type of shit. Like. I really had to adapt again, like figure shit out. So,
The paranoia should be different. The
paranoia was a whole another level for you, but I don't know, man. It's just that it's no filters because of who you are, and I just think you did a amazing thing for you. We always looked at it like this, right? I looked at it like you was like Wink, and Meek was like DMX.
Yeah.
That's how I used to.
Yeah, that's
look
how
at
we, that's
it. Really,
that's,
it really,
and that was just
like
definitely the terminology that we used for it. Yeah. That's exactly how it went down.
I just think even with myself or Wayne, you know what I'm saying? Because how I always looked at you like family and like
yeah,
I said,
sure.
I
would
call you and
love,
hit you
too,
with
for sure.
Positive shit. But it was just that for you to be in a space that you was in a culture, like you had a lot on your shoulders. You wore a lot on your shoulders at 13.
Yeah, that's a
fact. That's what niggas keep so when he say, yo. I've been doing it. It's kind of solid because he was 12 and 13.
Yeah,
he really
been doing
noise.
It. Yeah, he was.
At the height of his career, nigga was 13. Yeah.
And would not listen to our asses.
Wouldn't listen.
I got, probably 10 plus years in the pack, right?
Wouldn't listen. Yeah, definitely.
Wayne keeps saying, like,
he wouldn't listen.
Yeah.
He just won't listen. That conversation we had the other day, where he was like, see, you fucked up. Call him and let him know. Call him and let him know. He was like, yo. I said, yo, Wayne said, now y'all niggas get it?
A nigga had some. He had a lot of valid situations that happened that one of us older ones told him. And after it happened, you sit there and you be like, I told you so.
Yeah.
I told you so. And he be sitting there like, no, but what I was trying to do was.
But sometimes you got to.
Because like.
It goes like, sometimes, you know, you got to.
His situation.
Understand it.
His situation with Poopo.
Right.
Oh, yeah.
Charlie, and I'm over your shoulder the whole time telling you,
Charlie,
don't ride that 150.
Listen.
Don't ride
that
150.
Because at the time, we was low with 150s. At the time,
it
wasn't a smart choice. Charlie, we had a 100. We had
a brand new
Charlie 100. Had, matter of fact, at the time, I'm on Charlie bikes.
Yeah, they was
on
Charlie
bikes. Charlie had fucking 20 bikes for you to pick from.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Charlie, like, get on this 100. I'm like, nah, I'm riding this. You tripping. I'm riding this. I'm in love with this 150 at the time. So
what went through your head?
But, you know, at the time, I wasn't even supposed to. I don't even think I was supposed to wheelie against him.
No, you're supposed to wheelie against Alex.
That's the little brother and shit.
Okay, right.
So, man. So then when we taking off, he's like, are you wheeling against him? At the time, I don't care who I'm wheeling against. But if I was on a better bike, I know that whole situation would have went different. So, bam, as soon as we pick up. Man, I only seen Pupo probably for like 2 minutes of the wheelie.
Gone.
Yeah, he was long gone.
Gone ain't the word, man. That nigga, I don't know what type of wrist he had on
he
that
was
fucking
long
he
gone.
Was out.
Man, that nigga was out. He was out. I swear to God, I probably seen him for like a couple blocks, even though we on the highway, a couple blocks. However many blocks I seen him for, but after that, I didn't even see Pupo no more. So it felt like I'm really wheeling by myself.
Right.
So I'm going to put this motherfucker down whenever I put it down. But what happened was the fucking gear winded out.
That's what Charlie was telling him. He said, yo, the gear's too short. Yeah. You can't do that distance battle on this thing. You're going to blow this motherfucker up.
And that once that gear starts winding out, it's either you put that motherfucker back in the pocket and slow it down, or it's going to go down on its own. Mm. And that's what happened. And then like at, like back then, that shit was after that still cool. Still, I rode with
this nigga trapping. This nigga trapping on the radio.
I rode with Pupo after that. Like, you know what I'm saying? But now they turn battles into some other shit.
Oh, no, the battles is a whole
shit different.
Battles that cost you $1 million a battle, nigga, right now.
For sure.
But it's so much.
Let's get into like,
let's get into, cause
I be wanting to get into like who inspired. Like,
yeah, tell the people this who inspired whole, you.
No, I just want, correct me if I'm wrong. No,
it's about you.
Yeah, correct me if I'm
tell
wrong.
Tell them who inspired
like,
you.
Who inspired me? You know who inspired me. Lips. I make sure I make that shit known on any interview who right. I learned my whole, that, he.
What made it so great to you, what he did?
What made it so great? Different.
I know that, but I need everybody don't know remember, that. You gotta explain that.
Now remember videos like United Trenches and shit. You remember that? Oh, this is old videos. You won't even know about if you wasn't into the bike shit
right,
back then.
Right.
Super. He been Superman and he been one hand
scraping
and
the curb.
He been doing all the shit. It's just
you know what
Liz
did that I still to this day have never in my life seen somebody do. He scraped the fender on a PW50.
Yeah, he was. They don't even remember.
They don't even have a fender, my nigga. He was way back here to hit the bitch
the
on the ground.
Nigga was
like,
4'8". He was dumb little. Yo.
They don't remember. Like, see, I see. This how much they don't even remember Lips in his DS80 days. No, I'm talking about the DS80s, the Jigsaw with the naked girl all over. You remember that, Wayne?
Jigsaw with a
naked.
Oh,
yeah,
the
motorcycle.
That's when all those motorcycles. The orange. I'm talking about back, though.
Yeah,
back.
He was wheeling that shit.
I'm talking about this shit back in the day. Like, that's how long I was studying him. And then I wound up growing up. Him and my brother was always cool and shit, my cousin. And I'm growing up now. We hanging together. All us hanging together. He's me, my brother, it. my cousin and shit. Yeah, hell yeah. So, and then He started buying all them bikes and all that shit, and then I started riding his bikes and all that type of shit, and I'm still like, even when I got nice, I still was paying.
This nigga
paying.
Was never buying
still,
his own
still
damn
going to
bikes.
Taking the niggas' bikes.
Yeah, for sure.
Listen, he had a heart attack one day about you having his bike.
Yeah, for sure.
Crazy.
I ain't out on my bike. He ain't called.
He about to take my bike out like that.
Yeah, he ain't.
That nigga had a heart attack one day.
He got your attitude quick.
Yeah, that nigga, he's different, man. But
he was inspired.
Yeah, I was inspired. Like somebody, and like he inspired my whole everything with bikes. Taught me how to ride. He inspired my whole riding style and everything. And then I just took my shit to the next level. You know what I'm saying? Like,
now,
for sure.
How did you start? All right, so we on this show we debate about all the time, dirt bike capital, trend setting shit, da 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 da. When you seen a lot of tricks that y'all started go global, how'd you look at it then?
I felt like. Me, truthfully, I felt like that was what was going to happen because we started the shit. You understand what I'm saying? It's supposed to went global. But just show some respect. That be my only thing. Like, when y'all, when these niggas be getting up there saying, I'm better than such and such, I'm better than Chino or this, that, and the third, I be really sitting back. Like, y'all niggas be forgetting none of y'all was really off the steps yet when I was riding. Mm. Literally. Can I make this up, Wayne?
No.
Nigga, you was not. 13.
That's what I'm saying. 12. So, like, I'm already 5 years in when these niggas started getting nice.
No, when they first got their first bites.
Well, first bites, if that's how we put
it. Kirk said it best, though, but Kirk said it, Kirk from Atlanta. Kirk said, when y'all, because I don't think Chino came when y'all went to Atlanta the first time.
Yeah.
Chino,
he ain't go with us.
The first time they went to Atlanta, they took an RV down there. And Kirk said, when them niggas left, Kirk said, every nigga in Atlanta is going to know how to tune. know how to do all these tricks.
Yes.
And it happened.
Yes, but that'd be my main
that
thing.
That was the same when we first took him to New York.
Yeah, oh, he was scared to go across the bridge.
Yo, almost fell out.
Word on the street,
that shit's so crazy.
Word on the street, you scared
this
to go across
so crazy,
that bridge.
We actually, we cool now. I like
Al Capone.
It wasn't Al Capone.
No, Al Capone was like,
you mean to tell me this little motherfucker dancing on his seat
go across the bridge.
And he's scared to cross a bridge?
It ain't even that we cool now. It never was really no. It was that situation happened, and then after that, Hollywood stunts and shit.
Okay.
He was doing the donuts. Not them donuts. He was swerving his shit side to side. Remember on the bridge?
Yeah.
On the bridge, he was swerving the Banshee side
they
to side.
Drip
and
side
I'm
side,
like
yeah.
directly behind him. I mean, beside him, but I'm wheeling. Mm-hmm. And I think we had like a few words. Did we? I think it was like I said something to him.
Said something.
I said something to him or some shit. But it wasn't no tension or nothing like that. Right. But I said something to him and shit like that because we was on the bridge and shit. I really thought I was about to fall off
the
bridge.
They said you
should
fuck with them bridges.
No.
That nigga got off that seat immediately, sat his ass down,
sure.
did not wheelie till we got to the other side.
Sure.
Yeah, that's my
guy. You know, what the fuck we was going at? I think we was going to Queens.
And you know what's so crazy? Not all my shit always tied back together. Who brought me to New York?
Va.
Wow.
Va brought me to New York. Mm. Yeah, that was my first time riding in New York. We all pulled off from that storage.
Yeah,
you know what I'm
talking
about?
Yeah, we down
for
them.
Yeah, for sure. Actually, I had a great time. That was like one of the best rides in New York that I've been to. Yeah, for sure.
I mean, the foundation is there. I mean,
hold up.
The Dirt Bike Capital, it got inspired.
All right, but Shay.
Yes, sir.
We skip over the whole shit. Because when these niggas come on here, I need them to, because that's the question. I want that to be like a main question.
What's that main question?
Who inspired your whole shit? I know who inspired me.
Okay.
Lips inspired my whole shit. Right. So I just be wanting them niggas to be honest when they come on here and say they the GOATs and this, that, and the third. I'm not even calling myself the GOAT no more.
I never liked that GOAT shit.
Everybody has their inspirations.
We do have a video of his ass walking around the neighborhood with a real fucking goat. But hold up. So the girl walking around with real goats
for
in the
sure.
neighborhood.
That's a fact.
I think a lot of time it's just the ego, man. And some people don't like to give it up.
I can get up here all day. I've got much further than Lips and Bike Life and things like that. I can get up here all day and say, Lips ain't fucking with me, or this person ain't fucking with me, or this stuff. I will never say Wayne ain't fucking with me.
Out of
respect him.
Out of respect.
You get what I'm saying? I respect his bike ride.
Hey,
you get what I'm saying?
Some shit you just can't do.
Niggas like Charlie. I will never say Charlie. It's just out of respect. I respect niggas
who
I was
watching. We call him washed
up
though.
Yeah, for sure. You know how we gonna do. You already know that.
We gonna call Charlie washed up though.
We gonna talk bad about each other just to make each other
Just to make each other ride.
Yeah, for sure.
And that's growth though, and you've grown.
And that's what people get it mixed up though. They think you're throwing shots at each other.
Sure.
Oh, he hating, he mad. No, we throw shots at each other all day.
Wayne used to be on your ass.
Why would y'all just call me when I walked on here, the model or this, that?
Yeah,
you think I'm gonna come in here, man?
That nigga,
some shit
that nigga used to be on your ass. Be like, I'm gonna tell him something. I'm like, yo, Chino. I had to call Chino.
But another thing, Wayne also understood it. You understand what I'm saying? So that's what really matter. You know what I'm saying? He understood it, but he I understand. We going to play. That's how. Ain't nobody getting any feelings. Too much animosity and too much tension.
I'm glad y'all start listening now. From that conversation the other day.
Yeah, for sure.
I'm glad he was up one on that one. He's like, I told him.
Yeah, but and like I said too, like I'm coming back out this summer. I'm saying this on Let's Take a Ride. So all you niggas, let's take a ride.
You gonna bring your goat?
For sure. I'm putting the goat in the back seat. Wayne, listen,
no
real shit. As we speak, is a bike being delivered to Wayne right now.
He ain't not riding no damn way.
I am coming back out. I'm putting the motorcycles up, the van, the
they
home.
They deliver the bike straight to you.
Straight to Wayne.
Every bike
get delivered to Wayne, because Wayne is who going to put my shit together, and I trust
the shit
with all
be funny,
my
though,
shit.
Because the truck will pull up with the bike in the crate, and he lowering the shit down, and we'll sit there and say, yo, you got to take that back there. And he like, how the hell I'm supposed to get that back there?
Like,
we like, yo, you got to figure it out.
I remember when he put the first bike together, he's like, I'm not letting it ride it right now. I ain't going to put the oil in it. He's like, I ain't putting the oil in it. He think he going to come get this motherfucker right now.
Sure.
I was right there with that one.
He wanted that Dan Keggs 100. They put that shit together. How long that shit last? You got rid of that shit immediately.
and begged for that 100.
He wanted it so bad.
He wanted it so bad.
Matter of fact,
the Kings wanted it.
I remember them calling the same day.
Yeah.
I put it together. We hit Hilton Parkway, made the video.
Right.
You on the bike? You're riding the bike on Hilton Parkway, and Monster calls us and tells us to peel the graphics off of it.
Yeah. That shit was crazy.
And we like, what? Yeah. Why did y'all put it on there if y'all didn't want him to ride it in the streets with it on there?
It was at a certain point, like when I could, because it was too much in the media and shit. That shit like started getting like
now they understand our culture.
That was when remember the shit on it kept coming on the news. Like kept coming on the news.
But I'm like, they already knew what you were gonna do with it.
I understood.
So why did y'all even put the graphics on the bike?
Just really didn't want
that. Now they understand the culture.
They could have left it stock, is what I'm saying, though. They could have sent them a stock KX 100 with the original Kawasaki, but they had to put Monster all over it, and then when he ride it, they tell him to peel it off.
I feel like everybody is starting to understand our culture now. Like, our shit is just, our shit is bigger.
It's ours. Nobody created this. This came birthed in the cities.
The whole 21, I feel like the whole 22, like, the 21 and 22 going to be a great year for bike life, I feel like. And I'm coming back.
How you feel about this
and
word?
We got this great podcast.
No, the podcast. Right? But how you feel about this word? When they go, we just want to capture you. They want to capture your lifestyles. That's their favorite word. They want to capture.
I mean, some
captures
shit,
make sense.
No, real shit. Some of the shit about them capturing, some of it makes sense for me. I would say it makes sense for me.
Okay.
You get what I'm saying? Because of the shit that I be having going on and things like that, I be feeling like it makes sense. You know, I ain't letting, if I know it's some bullshit or something like that, I'm not really tapping into it. And then, like, my team and shit, we only doing what's authentic. For real.
Yeah, that's why we got Let's Take a Ride. it took us a minute to put it together, but we got it.
But, I feel, like I said, this shit right here is going to change our culture and also bring a lot of people into our world who don't know nothing about it. You know what I'm saying? Who don't know none of the stories or know where this shit come from or know who did what with certain shit.
A lot of the riders now, they curious.
Yeah.
They don't know the history, like you said. So it's like, they look at me, they look at Shay, they look at you, they sit there and say, what made him so special?
Yeah.
What the fuck?
Yeah, what did he
they
do?
See in him this, that's this so and special. That. And what? Why is he this person? Why did he make him so special? Why is he special?
Yeah. They always question it. They want to question it
so they don't know.
Yeah.
But and that's one of the reasons why we created the platform, so they can learn a little bit about it and they can understand. Because they say something dumb in the heartbeat like, Wayne don't do no tricks and all that shit. Why he got so many followers? You like what?
I feel like
just dumb.
I feel like it's all about how you market yourself, really. Like,
I mean,
I see you use your platform as marketing as well. You understand what I'm saying?
Yeah, like, I market sometimes. Yeah, I play sometimes.
But I feel like you got to be, like, marketable, and you just, like me, I'm not making my whole life ain't going to be based around. My whole page just not going to be a fucking dirt bike. Back then, it was never I feel like I gave brands and shit like that something to market. I didn't just give y'all, I ride 24/7.
He
didn't did
his brands. Yeah, he didn't did his brands, but I ain't going to lie to y'all. I'm not wearing no boxers with no chain, no face on them.
No, definitely not
going to
do that.
We're not doing that.
Yo, so,
I'm not
doing that. But no, really, like, I just feel like it's all about, like, how you market yourself with that shit. And And certain motherfuckers, they just make it all about, like, the bike shit. Like, I was fashionable while I was doing it and shit like that. And I was also doing other shit off the bike. Like, you see personality and shit like that. I'm not speaking about nobody specifically.
I can say that I seen you do 50 takes and get frustrated with Charm City King.
For sure.
I was like, yo, what the fuck? This nigga was getting frustrated for sure. 50 takes. Like,
that shit. That was my first time acting. So, and then it's like, I was in a position
where... How many times you said fuck that shit?
Especially on like... no, real shit. Like in the bike chases and shit like that. It was like... It was certain points. I'm like, yo, they telling me how to do shit
what
that
you
I
do.
Know. You get what I'm saying? But I also understood it was a certain moment or certain thing they have to capture to make it look good, because like we don't know about that Hollywood side of it. We know they know what sell. We don't know what sell. We just know we doing that shit.
We needed that chase scene to be sexy.
I was on it. They just wouldn't listen to me.
They wouldn't listen. Yeah, we needed that chase scene to be sexy.
You was deep in that shit.
I was inside the room with the monitors. I was on everything. I knew where all the cameras was. Everything. I was going outside telling the riders like, look, this where you want a wheelie at right there so we can catch the scene. Yeah. And then they just edited so much.
I was just trying to kill more people for y'all in the movie, but they wouldn't let me do it.
MNC.
MNC, they didn't let me blow that hammer or nothing.
For sure.
But nah, but I mean, I think you got valid points on where you at with the culture, how you see the culture. The platform, the platform is dope, but at the same time, we're not going to filter it being the truth. Just because I'm from New York, I get fried about, but you see in the Capitol and this and that. And I always stand on the fact that, all right, New York was riding dirt bikes, yes, but they just started a trend. They raised the bar. You have to give credit where credit is due. Yeah. No matter what it was. That's Wink will forever be a legend. There's 1,000 motherfuckers better than him, but he's just a legend.
Yeah, that's for
hands
sure.
Hands down. Definitely you can't get around it. So you did a lot of stuff at a young age, man.
I'm calling Wink out this summer. Y'all laugh.
I don't do it.
Wink, I'm telling you now. I'm calling you out on an egg battle.
On a banshee.
On a banshee.
That'd be like
another thing.
Like that egg battle?
Yeah, I respect the egg battle.
Well, we be having fun with the egg battle.
I respect the egg battle because, like, I sit and every time one of these podcasts come out, I watch that shit. Y'all know how I be texting y'all about it.
You blow my phone up
with it. I blows y'all shit.
The egg battles don't be hilarious.
Because as soon as I seen this shit, you know how you just get like, now you just get so happy. Like, I got so happy for y'all to like that shit. I'm like, yo, this is something we never needed. You commented, always needed.
If you look on there, you commented on one of the videos so much that somebody commented under you and somebody say, please get this boy his interview.
Listen, that nigga called me 12 at night. You up? Listen, I said, listen.
I'm watching this shit. Called me 12 at night. Like, because y'all be, it be like, y'all asking the right shit, and I'm so happy because, it's, like I said, it's bringing people into our world. When I first seen this shit drop, I don't think I text you first.
Nah,
I text Wayne first. Wayne got probably 5 texts back to back from me. Back to back. Like little paragraphs too. Am I lying, Wayne? Mm-hmm. Little paragraphs. Right, like, right, this shit is gonna be major. This is gonna be just like I seen it. I automatically seen it. And it's also they gonna tap into it because most people, like, all they get from the riders is riding.
Right.
They don't get no
But we asking core questions. But see, and that's what it did. We asking core questions. We not going to water it down. I mean, there's even segments people said a lot of shit. We exposed it. Like, you said that. Yeah. How'd you feel about that when you said it? So, I mean, this ain't no filter. Then it's our shit. We going to ask the truth. I'm going to ask you all questions. You told me there is no whole ball. So is what it is.
It's fair game.
It is what it is. But I don't know, man. It's just, I think you did a lot for the culture. I think a lot of people was lost. Yeah. I think you did it at a young age, and Wayne said you ain't gonna come back.
No, he ain't riding that bike.
Summer. Wayne, the bike is on the way to your house, bro.
He ain't riding that bike.
I see you ride. When I ride the nigga, the nigga just go to the side, sit there, and then disappear.
You got it. He gonna come out with the pack. We gonna pull off.
Y'all see in Cleveland.
We gonna do like this, and y'all he gonna go this way, and he gonna put his bike back up. Yeah, okay. You gonna see him later.
We gonna see.
You gonna see him later.
Listen, because I want to ride with like some of the originals, like Steve, Charlie, the Nils.
Charlie ain't riding.
Charlie coming back out, bro.
He ain't riding either.
Charlie coming back out. Like, Nail original riders.
That's what you want to ride with, the originals.
Yeah, I just want to ride with, like, some originals. I feel like if we bring the fun back.
You get some of them out every now and then. Don't get me wrong. Man. I just be fucking with them all the time. Like, if they come out every now and then. But they won't come out every week like it used to be. Yeah. It's like they really don't. They not into it as much.
Man, this is for the Steves, the Charlies, the Nils, and I am coming back out this summer.
Okay, we'll see.
For sure, man.
Yo, who you?
Not even coming back out because I ain't never left.
But who the little young dudes that's inspired? Give me your top three young dudes that's on fire that you.
Young dudes.
Number one is Trayvon.
Oh, yeah, for sure. For sure, Trayvon.
I like Sean.
Trayvon.
That shit Sean did the other day was crazy.
Sean a monster.
Trayvon
got the swag.
He different.
He got the swag. He on point with his shit, but Sean is a fucking monster.
For sure.
That little boy.
Them two are
Sean on the YZ.
Yeah. Them two YZ, together. Yeah,
they different.
That's the dynamic duo.
They different. Yeah. But like, we can talk. We of course, you know, we breed different in Baltimore. We can talk about who's the top and shit like that in Baltimore, but like
you got just a worldwide thing.
Worldwide, like
so. Last question: you had an opportunity to see bike life, where would you like to see it go?
I want to see bike life. That's like my goal. I don't know if everybody think like my goal is to be like the only motherfucker who making money off bike life. That's not my goal. Mm. You understand what I'm saying? My goal is really to turn this shit into something like a league or something. I swear to God, like when I'm in meetings and shit with my team and shit, I always talk about building a league out and just like how can we help others. Like I just had a meeting the other day about some shit we trying to do with Monster, with like other riders, like also bring other riders on to it. You get what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. Like I really want to see everybody make a living because I did it. So now I know like it's really possible for other motherfuckers to make a living off riding dirt bikes.
After
like,
they told you to kiss your ass and he ain't shit, you still out there helping.
For sure. Yeah,
we do the just, same shit.
That's just how I'm set up. We do like, the same you know what I'm saying? There's and no then, favoritism. And then my thing, it'd be like somebody like me, he helped me. He helped me put me in position and took me into some most of these rooms and shit like that. And made my shit worldwide and global because I was known DMV wise and shit like that. But he just took my shit global and also took me in other rooms to get me sponsors and shit. And that's my man. I want to do that shit for somebody else or just if not the whole culture. Okay. You know what I'm saying? So that's my goal.
So what
do
you
it.
Think about this shit?
I think this shit is. I think this shit is fly.
Think it's fly? What makes it fly though to you?
The whole what makes
we don't got cologne. We only got like
what make what make this whole podcast fly to me is that I know that this podcast
because I'm here
for sure. You know that my OG for sure.
Right.
But I know that this podcast is going to be not just these sponsors. It's going to be way more sponsors on here.
Right.
Very soon, you understand what I'm saying? Okay. Because now it's a platform that they could really tap into.
Oh, so I'll be able to go
you understand what
like
I'm
this?
Saying? For sure. But now it's a platform that we can really tap into. Like, damn, we can really market off this podcast. They can really promote this on their podcast
because
they have this many subscribers. They got this many people watching. You understand what I'm saying? So this shit going to really be big and take out. This going to help the culture, too.
Yeah, we just need a lot of these riders to come on there and not twiddle their thumb and get all nervous in front of this camera.
And
that's
say stupid words
and
like don't fall. Have outlandish.
But no, y'all need to make that like a make that a top caption. And I want y'all to put the ones in the hot seat that be talking so much shit.
Who you want in the hot seat?
Whoever. I want y'all to just ask them, who inspired you? Who was you looking up to in this bike life shit to start riding or just to do these tricks and shit like that?
Yo, so let me ask you a question real quick because I know you got to go. You probably got a private jet outside. Look, if you was in a hot seat, let's put the 13-year-old Chino in a hot seat, though.
For sure.
You going to put the 13-year-old Chino in a hot seat?
13. Sure. Put the 13-year-old in a hot seat.
You put the 13-year-old Chino in a hot seat, and I'm going to ask my own question.
All right, so I'm going to put the 14-year-old Chino in a hot seat.
Yeah.
Who you want to smoke with?
Back then?
Fuck your city.
You,
just
you
call 13, it out.
14.
It's 14.
Then, that's what
he's
saying. When you 13, 14.
13, 14. At that point, there really wasn't nobody to want smoke with because it wasn't no riders.
But who if you was 14 years
right
old.
Right now.
Today, right now if you was 14.
I want smoke with everybody that got Chino name in their mouth.
Give me three.
Give you three? I'm going to give you. I would say. I ain't even going to say him. Because he on another type of bike. I was just in Atlanta the other day, and I swear I was in Atlanta the other day. Somebody walked up to me in the club and said, "We got 5,000. We got five. I don't know his name. We got 5,000. I don't know. We got 5,000.
On Fruit.
No, it wasn't Fruit. Fruit got the dreads, right? Had the dreads.
No,
that's not Fruit.
No.
Which one had the dreads from Atlanta?
That's the Quell.
Quell. That was Quell. It might be Fruit. Light skin dude.
Light skin.
I think that's who walked up on me. Yeah. We in the restaurant.
You trying to eat your food.
Restaurant type club.
Right.
I'm sitting over there. We at the table. He got one of his mans to walk over there. Yeah, my man got, we got 5,000 right now out front. The bike. So I'm sitting in here. We sitting in a restaurant. You
eat my food.
We just chilling. You talking about dirt bikes. We really enjoying the environment. Things
right, going right, on. Right.
But yeah, probably him. Okay. Just because of what he did in there. Right. And who else? I don't even know.
How does it feel when Meek get into his bike altercations with people knowing he's not nice on the bike, and you got to fight his battle for him.
I don't. You know what's so crazy though, Wayne? I don't really got a fight no Meek battle.
With no, every time he got into a bike altercation, you always jumped in and tried to fight his battle.
You know, I got that's my dog because he gonna jump in.
No, but why did you do it though?
Probably because whoever probably was coming at him know that damn well they fucking way nicer than him or something. No, real shit though. Like that's like lame. You get what I'm saying? Like
that's like old vibe change. Yeah, that's like
me. Like that was a good question. That's like me. Like coming at. That's like me coming at Trayvon. What the? Like you gonna be like Chino? You picking? You get what I'm saying? You know you nicer than Trayvon. Like, why are you even saying something to him?
Right,
you get what I'm saying? Meek got bike walks. You can't deny that. He can he can ride. You get what I'm saying? We got the old videos of him on the Banshees and shit like that. Like, you got to respect
one more question.
Walks.
Meek or Fetty, who you got winning?
I got Meek on the Banshee. For sure.
I take that bet all day.
For sure.
I take that bet all day. On the Banshee.
Wayne.
I take that bet all day.
Wayne.
I take that bet all
day. I'm not just saying that. I'm not just saying that because that's my dog.
I take the
bet
all day.
I'm not saying that, but you got to understand the fundamentals of ride. Meek got time on this belt with ride.
I take that
Fetty
bet all
don't
day.
Really got no time. I what he got 3 years?
Is we gonna take that? Is that y'all gonna take that? Y'all
what he got 3 years?
Look, I don't know, look, but we would just want to see it.
Tell you, we never know if that'll happen.
Look,
but
tell your man.
You know,
tell your man.
Right or wrong, though. So
egg battle.
Yeah.
Egg battle and
donate to a charity.
Donate to a charity for the loser.
Yeah. Sure. That, but you know what's so crazy? That'd
distance.
On distance
on the bench.
That'd be some fly shit. But Wayne, you really think that?
I never seen
Fetty with no distance. I seen the videos and shit.
I'll take that bet all day.
I don't think so.
And donate to a charity.
I'll take it all day.
I don't know.
He'll take the bet. I ain't even got to call him. I know he'll take the bet.
Homie gonna take the bet.
Yeah, for sure.
I think that'll happen.
I think I got the hat, man.
That's beautiful.
Yeah, I take that all day.
But thanks, man.
Well, I appreciate y'all bringing it.
Yeah, we got to get out of this damn
stage. I appreciate that shit.
Now, stand up for the camera and model.
Yeah, for sure.
Because you know you got to be the model. Stand up and model because you ain't riding no bikes.
Let's take a ride.
So stand up and model.
Special delivery. How you doing today?
Right. Sorry, I mean to get you up. We came by late yesterday. But...
Hey, Chino, I got that special delivery for you, shorty. Too bad I'm going to be the first one to ride this shit.
Yeah. Know what it is, we back, new 450, shout out my guy Willie Wayne, you know, always getting my shit when it touched down, shout out Monster, new 450, you know how we come in the summer, let's get it.
Now you get ready to do a whole bunch
let's
of bluffing.
Let's take
a ride. You get ready to do a whole bunch of bluffing now.
I forgot how it started.
Look, that's terrible.
It's Chino. I appreciate y'all bringing me on. Let's take a ride, man. Shay, Wayne, I appreciate y'all. Look forward to seeing this podcast go to new levels and shit, you know. And let's take this bike life shit to another level, man. Let's get it. Let's take a ride.
I know this bike life, I know what this life like. I'm flipping that throttle. Streets got me feeling like Mike. Right. I'm talking A-Fab and Cherry Hill. For years they heard about the stories that we legends still. Let's take a ride. From my side to your side. Let's take this worldwide. Let's take a ride, ooh, let's take a ride. Oh, this for Willie Wayne and this for Shay. Let's take a ride, ooh, let's take a ride.
New York, pretty in the summer.
Riding Apple, baby.
It ain't no pity in the rain.
Heat makers.
Home of sundresses and cocaine. Might score out here. What all
my efforts is so effortless. Like, I cheat these raps like cracks when I was chefing bricks. Blindfold me in the kitchen or anywhere next to it.
I got it.
Dear fuck your bitch, you can put an X next to it. 130 is like a Glock with an extra clip. I call my bitch to make sure she got an extra bitch. I buy a burnout phone just so I can text a hit. Set a nigga up, they always fall for a sexy bitch. Especially in the summer with a sundress. A 45, I make a grown man undress. Pussy nigga lucky the gun jam like Summerfest. Think about yes behind my tan when I